We'll be back more strictly right after this. Tonight on BBC One. It's the epic two-part finale everyone will be waiting for. It's bigger than last season, longer than last season, and so shocking than last season. And Doctor Who, the two-part finale, coming tonight on 7:10.
Mm-hmm. And skip.
Skip the Doctor Who two-part finale? Lee, what has got into you?
Aw, man, not you, Infinite fanboy. Look, I'm done every finale, every ending now.
What? How can you say that? It's all built up for one of the companions last Chawla. I mean, I think that Graham is gonna leave. I mean, that's it, babe. He's not coming back.
This could be the last time you're ever gonna see Bradley Walsh's beautiful smiley face.
Look, I get it. I get Bradley Walsh is a good character, but he's the chase. He has to move on with something else. I mean, he has to move on the chase. He's a catch from that. You can't keep him in the Doctor Who. I don't matter who's gonna leave. He's gonna leave. I mean, people won't make sad about that. I mean, I'm sad that every TV show has been cancelled. Like, the spin-off series. Class, Torchwood, hell, all the shows have been cancelled day after year. I just can't waste my time with the finales anymore.
Would you like a jelly, baby?
Really? I just have one in my packet.
Oh, come on, Lee. This is bigger than the other shows. This is the two-part finale, baby. All the companions are facing the Cybermen. The thrills get robbly, mongely, and shocking, and very, very confusing. But do you ever think it was good since Dave Tennant and Matt Smith joined together since the 50th anniversary special?
Yeah, it was kind of good at the 50th anniversary. All the Doctors, well, any footage from the 50th over the last 50 years was kind of good. I mean, Dave Tennant. I mean, I'm glad of him in the back in the anniversary.
And what about that time when on season 4 on the Dave Tennant era when on Stone Earth when all the companions faced the Daleks and Davros stopping them and stealing all the planets and all the planets of the sky.
Daleks, man, best bad guys ever.
Yeah, it was kind of like a crossover, like they fought in the Owlverses.
See? I knew you can get along.
No, stop. I'm only doing, stop it. See, I didn't forget what happened last year. You know what happened on the season 10 finale? The Doctor falls. What a common little abominable mess.
What, you didn't like when John Sim came back as the Master?
Oh yeah, I like John Sim back as the Master, but there's only one thing that's so annoying me, the Cybermen. I mean, they're the most annoying main villains in every finale. What happened on season 8? I'll tell you. They kill off Daddy Pink. Hell, the guy who only had days with Clark Oswald, if they can just have nice kids to each other and nice kisses and then get married. I thought that we could do like a wedding episode.
Well, they already did that on season 6 with River Song.
That was not even a proper wedding episode. And also the season 10 finale. What the Cybermen did in this episode? This episode. I'll tell you. They killed Bell Potts. Hell, the companion ought to be around in the season because it's Stephen Moffat's last season. And also the classic Cybermen. I like the classic Cybermen back as well in the 1966 version as classic. But the only thing that so annoying me that they make them so horrifying. I mean, like Gotham. How are you going to use that in an episode? See, I mean, they call the whole thing the Doctor Falls because it said the Doctor's gonna die. Don't give me that crap. You use that reference on season 9 when we mentioned about me. You remember me? Who plays Maisie Williams? Or became immortal? But you remember that reference he'd used on Captain Jack? But didn't bring him back. John Bowman since before. You can't use that in every finale. I'm out. No more. I'm drawing a line at the ending!
Oh, come on, Lee. Are you really going to tune out?
If you skip this two-part finale, you're going to miss all the amazing fan fiction.
No, stop it. This isn't going to work on me.
John Martin is playing as the Doctor again, and he's going to be helping the Jolly Witch to feed the Master. It's a two-dot story back again. Is that something you always want to see?
I kindly bought the two Doctors story when with my mum's favour if they promised for her for a two Doctor story.
plus Shagadoran is coming back as the master? Your childhood villain's been around all those years and you're not going to support him?
No, no, stop it!
Come on, Lee.
We know you want to.
Well, maybe I'll watch the first half. We'll see how it is.
No! No! No, no, no! I went too far! Every year I get drawn in the endings of Doctor Who, see what happens next season, or another season, or the other season after that, but this time I finally have enough!
Except for tortured Eddie class to see more sexual, more love.
Wow, you changed.
No, I've grown. See, that's the problem. Doctor Who has it. You always burn. Every time they use ideas, they run out. Because this season is always set on Earth. And people want to see an alien planet. It's always been not futuristic. I was pissed off since what happened in episode 3, because it was scary. These creepy golden monsters. But I mean, it just, I can't stand seeing how I can get crying in the ending again. I can't do that again like Billy Piper or Catherine Tate. And even Karen Gillan. But Lee, this show gives you all the characters you always wanted. Look, I get it, alright? Look, I love Doctor Who. It's been my fan series for the last when I was 7 years old. I was put off until crying since what happened in Avengers Endgame. But still, I just don't even understand it. I mean, every time it gets gooder, it always gooder to push up to the next level. I mean, see what all everything revealed. I mean, the doctor's name or Gallifrey, even the master. I mean, I just can't ready for the truth again. I just can't wait. I just can't stop. Let the change corrupt me. I mean, there are other shows that have been. Well, you know, are also like time travel series. A timeless, Back to the Future, some of the Hourverse TV shows that always compel the world. They stole stories and tell the reference of Doctor Who. But for that, Doctor Who may relation into these series. For that, I'm just gonna walk away. Besides, if I watch the ending, it make me cry. Make all my families cry. They will never see, because when they do, when they lost all the only favorite characters they have, if they're gone. That means people will never realise what Doctor Who is like now. And for that, I have to walk away. It's like River Song used to say, I don't like endings.
But Lee, are you forgetting something?
Oh no!
John Barman's coming back this time.
No! No! They didn't!
Oh, but it did, Lee. Your favourite Doctor Who character and also Torchwood is coming back to play Cam Jack Harkness for one last ride. Are you really going to miss out on that?
Two doctors and the master, including flying cyberheads. Ho ho ho, that gave me a new idea for a Doctor Who video.
God, I'm a really piece of crap.
Hello and welcome to episode 9.
Hi guys, welcome to the season 12. Oh, thank you, Lucy.
Yeah. This is Bonnie. He's my dog. He's my dog. He's enjoying my review. So tell me, Blue, what are your thoughts about this episode last week?
It's Bonnie Bubble.
Oh, Lucy's with us.
Bonnie Bebe.
Oh, take her.
Come here.
Thank you.
crummy a bit.
Ew. Yeah, yeah. So yeah, so welcome to season 12 with you and
she my baby.
And today we will be reviewing this week's episode of Doctor Who, and it's the two-part finale of season 12. We're near now for this mysterious timeless child and this roof doctor and including everything about that happened in the season. So yeah, so this episode is called The Ascension of the Cybermen. Yes, the Ascension of the Cybermen. It's been going around since the start of the season. Yeah, the Cybermen are returning as the.
Lacey Pop 9.
So yeah, the Ascension of the Cybermen. So yeah, I think that was called that. So what I thought about this episode? See, it was very complicated since around.
There's a lot of people.
Thank you, Lissy. Yeah. It's been complicated. Because there was this branding character in the episode. Thank you, Lissy. Yeah, and Gallifrey were turning in a portal that really confused me, and including the master returning and said that will change everything. Is something happening this season? Is changing the season? Am I losing my temper? Am I going to lose anything? My hope? This is what it'll be if I lose hope.
Don't.
Don't what?
Yep, I'll be like Hawkeye. So let's go on to review. So we'll talk about how many characters.
Too many
count. Well, yeah, there was the old man and Bradley Walsh and. Okay, I'll do the four actors in this episode so far. So we'll start with the first actor.
Right. So the first actor we're going to talk about in this episode is called Juliet Jarman. She plays Reavon. Reavon. Yeah, I think that's her name. People always give them daft names in the series. Juliet Jarman. Jarman. Yeah, she was a kind of Istrian character. Mom said she saw her somewhere before, because when I looked at it, she was from Shiteland. Yeah, that was the series that she was from. It was a series that aired about 20 since 6 years ago, and it cancelled last year. And also he's been with Paul McGann. We're calling Moving On. So what the fuck about her in this episode? She played like something from the Ghost Monument episode, and she played very well. I mean, chatting with Bradley Walsh and yeah, but it's kind of like they can get related, but yeah. So yeah, that's why I thought in that character. Yeah, that's very good. And she was kind of chatty one. Yeah, Well, I hope he should be good in the next part. And then the next one, that is maybe an important one, the character. So yeah, his name is Ian McCallie, Ian. Well, I think I'll call him Ian. Yeah, I recognise him. He was in that Krypton series last year, and also the year after that. Krypton is like a Superman series, but it was cancelled last year because it was not that good. I'm not sure anything about the Krypton. It's just you don't want to know. No. But anyway, I do like Krypton, but it's sad that it ended. But him in Doctor Who, yeah, I thought he'd be like something about the Cybermen, about the Mondasians, or like another Time Lord. But him, yeah, it's kind of like a bit like a Time Lord or more like Noah's Ark character. I like him back. I thought I recognized him somewhere, but I knew it was him from Krypton. Yeah, he played in Krypton. He played What did he play? He played one of Superman's grandfather. Yeah, so, yeah. Anyway, he played very good. He was very, very good in this episode. We hope we'll see more in this episode. See, we might explain about what happened in the ending. So, spoiler alert. This character, well, I hate to say it. Well, it's spoilers if you haven't watched it. Okay, you're warned. Okay, so yeah. So this character is called Evan McCabe. That's a very... Now he... Well, I think that's his real name. There are other characters who'll play the character. But we'll see. What he's act as. So yeah. But anyway, yeah. It's an Evan McCabe. So what about yeah? So his real name in the episode is called Brendan. But Brendan, what I thought about him in this episode. See, the episode being cutting off with him in the episode, and he's a boy that keeps growing, and then suddenly, in spoiler, he got shot and he fell off and he resurrected. Is he a Time Lord? I mean, but I don't see that how that's the point. Time Lords cannot come back to life, and they fall out and get killed and regenerate. But this one, I think it might be related to the Doctor. Because he could be the Master before he became so evil, or he could be the lone Cyberman in the episode. Yeah, the lone Cybermen is the villain in the episode. The Cybermen. So yeah, maybe it's him before he became the Cyberman. Maybe show like the first Mondasian, or it might do something to do with Gallifrey, or the Timeless Child. I don't know how he's connected. I don't know how Doctor's connected. It might explain everything for next week. But this week. Yeah, this week. So yeah, it's a very confusing episode with him cut in half. But anyway, he played a little bit good. I thought he could have done some more. I thought he revealed everything. So yeah, anyway, we'll see more. Maybe seeing more of him, or maybe another him. The next actor is always going to be my favourite, Bradley Walsh, aka
It is time to bring on the chaser.
So yeah, Bradley Walsh back again, and he was played very well in the episode. I mean, facing off the Cyberman, it was kind of like. Felt like from the end of time when with the Mott facing the Master, but not with him say facing the Cyberman. Well, I don't know what's gonna happen next week. Well, it's people saying that one of the companions may leave, because my reckon would be maybe Ryan or Yaz, but I don't mind which one of them will leave. I mean. I know every season and every two seasons with the Doctor in one version, the one companion always had to leave. I mean, Billy Piper left before David Tennant first season, and Karen Gillan left for the very half of season 7, and Jenna Coleman left. Season nine, around the second Peter Capaldi series, yeah, because every companion always has to, has to stay for two seasons or other two seasons or half season. But I don't. Well, maybe all of them might stay for next season, or we might a little bit change. One of them, because Bradley Walsh is not going to be in the next one, the next season. I don't know, but we'll see. But. Anyway, he played good, great work of facing the Cybermen. Okay, so that's all the characters. Now we're gonna go to the errors of the episode. So what about this error in the episode? See, people saying that this series always be on Earth, but now it's finally on an alien planet. All around the very end on an alien planet. That's kind of a good idea, but still, because of an idea. But anyway.
But anyway, an alien planet called Canlanda. Well, yeah, that's what I think that's what it was called. Anyway, Canlanda, that's a good location. Yeah, the location and the Krypton character, that's good to hear him in this episode. And yeah, including Gallifrey. Yeah, Gallifrey has returned. And but still destroyed. Gallifrey. It was never meant to be that.
I just drawn this.
Is that Gallifrey?
Ta-da, it's Unicorn and a Fox.
Blue, can you get him out? He's trying to disturb me. You should be reviewing me anyway.
Bubble.
Luke, okay, guys, break it up. Let's see, if you don't stop this, I'll never put another review.
I don't care.
Okay, so yeah, can you stop this? Yeah, so the
bubbles! Bubbles!
Okay, we'll skip the error. So, next.
Bubbles!
So, next we're gonna talk about the monsters in the episode. Yeah, the Cybermen are returning. Yeah, the Cybermen. So, yeah. So, what about the Cybermen? See, there was a great idea I thought I may use for my series. For my series, there was a spoiler. There were flying Cybermen on their heads. I mean, but can you stop?
Let loose to you, my ear.
Baldy, it's Baldy.
I'm not bald anymore. Get off! Yeah, the Cybermen. Yeah, I like the idea of the flying headless Cybermen. What do you thought about that, Lizzie? He said flying cyber drones because Lizzie said they used to do cyber drones, but no, they didn't. So yeah, it was kind of good that the cyber drones as flying Cybermen. Great idea. That's very good. Why do I look like a hyena? It was kind of good. It's kind of good. And and the master returning. I do like the shock twist. I've all expected we have to see the master, but I thought we expect like being in the ending like 5 minutes now, but now he's been 5 seconds ago. But anyway, it's gonna happen back. We're near to the series. I wonder what's gonna happen. I mean, and what's all about Brendan? I mean, and the character. So we'll see what it's gonna pull up. So yeah. So guys, that's the end of this review. If you guys want to comment down below, subscribe and like, and what you thought about this episode, just comment down below what you thought says this episode and.
Where's your pencil?
That's what you get. Yeah. So just comment reviewing what you thought about this episode. I thought it was like I.
What if they didn't watch the episode?
Yeah, well.
Roar, this is both now.
Let's get off.
Nom.
Yeah, I'm giving this episode 8 out of 10. So that was my.
I give it a 4 out of 10. I had no idea what happened.
It was confusing, I know.
What?
Next week will be the final episode and also our final episode of the season's world review. Yeah, always. I don't know they'll do another season.
Yeah,
I think I signed up for one. Yeah, that's good. So, yeah, Jordan Williams' first season. It might be her last, but I'm not sure, but we'll see. But anyway, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time in the next review, and that'll be the last. Tally-o.
Delete.
Blue, you're not Cybermen.
Next time.
Yeah, get off the camera. Blue, get off the camera. I beg you not to...
Exterminate.
Get out!
Exterminate.
I'm with the Daleks waiting this episode. Get out! Everyone off. Hey, Lizzy, why are you and I, Spaxley? No, guys, go back. Alright, let's take all this. Hey, that's what.
I'll take the camera.
Get all that. Give me the camera. Give me the camera. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching, everyone. I'll see you next week, and I'll get that.
That's the end of the video. Thank you. Goodbye.